spot, I think they're following.
So where does it get you, I guess, is the question.
Where does it get us, the government?
Yeah.
Okay, where does it get you? You know, the e-commerce trying to...
I think the only thing we can really do is impeachment. I know that we need to listen to Mueller, we need to listen to McGahn, we need to see the 6th evidence that's being hidden from us in the grand jury, we need to hear from Lewandowski, we need to hear from Daniel Donaldson in a more fulsome manner, and there may be some other people we need to hear from, but there's no question based on the volume, it's based on the information obstruction of justice that Mueller has his report, we'll hear more about on Wednesday, based on what he said about the press and attacks on the First Amendment, attacks on the judiciary, Hispanic judges, Clinton appointed, Obama appointed judges, et cetera, that he's ripe for impeachment. Will the Senate convict? No. The House needs to take action. They need to impeach him. We need to bring that impeachment forward. And if the Senate doesn't act, I tell you, the voters will respond at the polls. Trump will claim he is vindicated no matter if he's impeached or not impeached. He will claim he's vindicated.
So to be clear, though, what is there a political risk here for Democrats right now? I think the latest polling that we did at NBC News with the Wall Street Journal shows that 21%, just 21% of Americans believe that impeachment hearings, that this inquiry should begin, compared to 50% who say no and 27% who basically say keep doing what you're doing. So why would Americans all be on board, as you suggest, with impeachment?
Well, I'm not sure if those numbers are correct. The numbers I've seen say about 74% of Democrats favor impeachment and about 35% of independents do. I don't know.
35% is still a third of independents.
That's right, but that's a pretty good amount. And I think if you go forward with impeachment and you bring out information from McGahn and others, will be more likely to get evidence from our subpoenas enforced on appearances on the documents to be turned over, and we get that information, and it comes out that there'll be more and more people that will see what happened to our Constitution.
You heard an email message about Ron's ears and tail.
Yeah. What happened? Oh, really? Is she actually?
She's missing enough hair that it's noticeable.
That's hilarious.
We hadn't guessed what it was. I was like, yep, she pulled her hair.
That's.
So on that topic, you're going to hear from Robert Mueller next week. Obviously, in the middle of next week, assuming the timetable.
Your colleague, Representative Jerry Connolly of Virginia, not far from where we're sitting right now, said it would be arrogant of Robert Mueller if he didn't basically provide any new information outside of his report. He said that his testimony. Do you agree with Congressman Connolly? Would it be arrogant of Robert Mueller?
I'm not going to use those words, and I don't know. You know, Robert Mueller's done a great job in all of his roles for America. I think he will respond. And if all he does is tell us about the elements.
If he doesn't. Yeah.
If he tells us the elements of obstruction of justice, if he tells us that those elements were met when Trump asked Sessions to unrecuse himself, when he asked McGahn to go ask him to unrecuse himself, when he asked McGahn to change his statement and say he didn't do it, when he asked them to write a statement up, when they asked him to be fired by McGahn,
the values in the public area,
the elements of things. Right, if the elements were met, I think the statement were met. Instruction, and the only reason the president